I don't know for you guys, but for me, paying 80 to 100 bucks for a check engine light that is on to go see the mechanic with that, it can be anything from a fuel cap that is not tight enough, a small leak in the exhaust system, an O2 sensor that is malfunctioning. I don't know, and it frustrates me so much. It felt good. Welcome to Car Question, and we're testing the Thinkcar BD6. We already reviewed one of their products, the new car CDE900. Go see in the eye just here. And this time, this one is Bluetooth, so a little smaller as you can see. And I won't talk about the interface with you because it's pretty similar to the new car CDE900. But what I like and what I don't like about that product. First of all, there's the Thinkcar BD6 and the ThinkDiag Mini. Those are two products that are very similar, but there's a few differences more about what you can do with the product when you buy it. With the BD6, you get 5 functions for free instead of 0 with the ThinkDiag Mini. So you have to think about that when you buy the products. Will you use it? Is it useful for you? After that, I have to tell you my special warning. Like I said in the other video, I'm not a mechanic. I know things about cars, but I'm not a professional of codes, of problems with car in general. So yes, I can diagnose my own problems with my vehicle because I know my vehicle, but I won't be able to know all codes for all problems. So I need a little help sometime with Google or some forums to help me. So let's start with the things that I don't like about that product. First of all, you have to create an account, and it bothers me a little bit because I'm all about personal data. How is it used? Will they use it against me for advertising or anything? And I feel intrusive in some kind of way. I read the user agreement. In that document, you can find that they're collecting information in the app. It's normal for the keyboard. They want to know which code are you researching. It can be justified. But information to create a persona on the user, I'm not sure about that. It's pretty intrusive. There's also many downloads that you have to do in the app. You have to download for your vehicle. You have to download the programs, the apps, if you want to have the full function that you get with the BD6. And also, there's many sub-menus. You have to select the info. Do I know if it's a SHSL or SHLT for my car? I know it's a 4-cylinder, I know it's a 2-liter, I know it's made in Japan with a J in the serial number, but I don't care about the rest. Just make it simple, please. So you have to go back few menus to adjust the information and go back to the place you wanted to be initially. But there's many good points about that product. What I like now is there's no need to buy the full version like the last one. Maybe they listen to us. Tell us, Thinkcar, if you listened for the new car CDE900. Also, there's a real-time data stream, so it allows me to diagnose my car myself. For example, I had an O2 sensor that was malfunctioning, so I could see exactly in real-time what was wrong. Was it the catalytic converter? Was it the O2 sensor? It was just great. You can select which one you want to see. You don't have to scroll it all. You can just select what you want to see in real time. So big thumbs up for that. There's also a community with that app. So be careful because there's multiple languages and often messages are from Thinkcar. So I think the idea is great, but the community is still too small. If there were a bigger volume, more messages, more people that were to use it, maybe it would be a lot more useful. But some of the messages are so specific for vehicles that I won't go see. I prefer to go to forums and things like that with my specific brand of vehicle that had the same problem as I had. After that, there's also a lot of accessible information. And one thing I discovered that late in my review, there's a button when you create a report, it's called ThinkGPT. ThinkGPT, ChatGPT, is it the same? Kind of, because it's AI that tells you what's wrong with your car and some clues, maybe some cues to help you find the problem and what to do to fix it. With my O2 sensor, I was thinking, what do I do? I just went on the ThinkGPT. It tells me 9 different things I could do to help or in steps. And I just go to Google. It helped me very much. Talking about price now, This product is a bit over $100 as you see on the screen just here, but there's also the ThinkDiag Mini. So if you don't need the 5 function as you saw sooner in the video, I would suggest you more to go with the ThinkDiag Mini. It's like $70. There's a few rebates at the moment that I recorded my screen. We did the review. It had a rebate of $20. So it's pretty interesting. It's not too expensive. So I would recommend maybe that you take that into consideration. Also, you talked to us about the Bluedriver. It's a really popular product. I know there's a lot of good reviews on Amazon. So tell us, do you want us to review that OBD2 scanner? Tell us in the comment section down there below. Do a thumbs up and see the video here that you may like about what we did. So see you another time at Car Question.